I got some new pants and I thought it would be fun to show you guys. I actually ran out of my favorite pants, or like one of my favorite pants, and then I wanted to order them online, but there was this like whole order limit, so that was a good excuse to just basically get more pants. So I was like, yeah, why not? And then I thought it would be fun to show you guys which ones I actually got. So the first one is this Pilot Friction pen in black. And I really like this pen because you can simply erase it with the back of the pen. Basically, the ink disappears with heat. So if you really rub on the paper with the back of it, yeah, it fades away. And that's really nice if you're like me and you try to plan your day, but then everything changes. So I got this one with like 3 refills in it as well, because it does run out quite quickly. But yeah, I think this is a good mix of like the actual pen and then some of the refills. So I'm happy that I have it now again because I ran out of it. And then I found out that they also have markers now. They have the super bright ones, but they also have this like lighter and softer toned colors. So I thought I would just get those. There are 2 sets of it. Each has 3 different colors in it. So the first one has an actual really bright yellow, and then a pink one and a blue one. I would say I do like the other set a bit more, but I just wanted to get all the colors basically. And then they're just like regular markers, with the exception that you can actually erase them. So I think that's pretty cool if you want to use them for like planning or something like that, and you know it might change, because you can easily remove the color again. And then like I said, there were 2 sets. So I also got the other one. I think I prefer this one when we look at the colors, because this one has like a greenish blue color, a muted yellow, and a purple one. And yeah, they look really good actually. They have the same kind of shape as the black pen, and I do like it because that means that they have good grip, and they just, yeah, they're just nice. They have this like nice feeling in the hand. So definitely can't wait to use these in my new planner. I'll do some time planning there, so it's good to have these colors to mark sections during the day. So I'm really happy that I finally got these. And then lastly, I got some gel pens, which I show you shortly, because apparently I wanted to show you all the colors first of the markers. These are the Uniball Signo pens. I've heard really good stories about them, but I've never tried them before. And they had this set with like a white one, a gold, a silver, and a bronze. I thought it would be a good selection to just try it out. They had metallic ones and glitter ones, and these are the metallic ones. But I'm also really curious for the glitter ones. And what I noticed right away is that they're like really sturdy pens. They're really well designed, because usually gel pens can feel kind of cheap. But this looks really good. And I also like the color selection, because I think this works great on black, and it can also look great on white. So they're nice for using in spreads. So yeah, I really wanted to try these, so I was happy that I could get some of them. And they weren't even that expensive, so that was also really good. And then of course I wanted to do some swatching here. So I got my Archer & Olive journal, which is almost filled up now, so I can use it for these kind of things. Just to show you what it looks like. And then I realized that because of the way of how I hold my pen, you can basically see nothing, so that's kind of stupid. But I will of course show you some close-ups as well. But what I like about this pen is that it writes really smoothly. It's not really black, it's sort of like a faded black. So that's something to keep in mind if you really want to have a dark black one, and this is not the one for you. But like I said, I think the biggest benefit of it is that you can erase it. So that's a really good benefit for me. So if you can show that, basically you take the back of the pen, it has a little like rubber tip, and then because of the friction, it will create some heat, and that will remove the pen. And usually I still see like small bits of it left, like really light, but I don't really care because usually I write over it again anyway, so that works out really well. And then the same applies to the markers, of course, which I found really cool because you can just wipe away color. That's cool. So first I want to do some swatches, and like I said, the bright yellow one is actually really bright. I wouldn't call it a like muted color, but the other yellow is really nice, so I'm really happy with that one. And then of course I'm swatching all the other colors as well. I think my favorite from all the colors is the muted yellow one, the greenish one, which I'm showing you right now, and I also really like the purple one. I think they go together really well and they look really nice. I'm not really a pink person anyway, and blue one doesn't look that special either, so that's why I picked the other three colors, I guess. But overall they look nice. They work well, so that's great. So if you look up close, you do notice that they're not like fully opaque. Like you can kind of see where I didn't go quick enough with the color. But yeah, like in reality, it doesn't really bother me. I've been using them a lot and they're great. So here I'm trying to write over it with the black one, but also the other way around. So write first and then do the highlighting. Both works great. There's no smudging at all. So together, like the black pen and the markers also work great. And of course, I wanted to see what happens if you try to remove it. So I went for the blue one. Again, it's similar with the black pen. Like you have to put in a lot of pressure to get all the color away, which is fine, but it also depends on the paper that you use and the quality of it. Like the Archer Nolliff paper is great, so it can definitely deal perfectly with doing this a little bit more firmly, I would say. But if you use like regular printer paper, for example, maybe you don't want to put in so much pressure. But again, I think it's great. I mean, I've been using them in like my time planning that I've been doing, and it's great that you can simply remove the color and also the pen if you mess up. So I'm a big fan there. And then of course I also want to try the gel pens, and keep in mind that this is the first time that I'm using them, so you will notice that sometimes they kind of skip a little bit, and that's what I usually see with gel pens anyway. If you haven't used them for a long time, or if you're using them for the first time, you maybe first want to write on a separate piece of paper to get the ink going again. But I was really impressed with these, except for like the small bits and pieces where I had the skipping issue. They actually looked really nice. The colors are nice. They're metallic, like I said, so it's not like a glitter one, but like a really metallic color. So I really want to try the glitter one as well. But they look good. And then, you know, if you have the problem with the skipping, just write the whole word again over it, because I only did the last part, and you will notice that it looks a little bit weird. But I think you can easily correct this by just rewriting the whole word, basically. Yeah, and then of course I wanted to try the gel pens in my black journal as well, because that's what I wanted to get them for, to also write on black. And you know, white doesn't show up on white, but white does show up on black, so that was good to try as well. And I'm super impressed with the white one. Usually I use the Sakura Jelly Roll pens, and I think this one is very similar when you look at how opaque it is and how good it looks. The tip is quite broad, broader than the ones from the jelly, like the jelly roll pens. So that's something to keep in mind. If you want a really small tip, maybe look at those. If you want a broader tip, look at the Uniball Signo ones. And then all the colors actually showed up really well on black. I think that's because these are the metallic ones. I could imagine that the glitter ones don't really show up. The metallic ones, they look great, even on black. So I would definitely recommend these. Again, I had a bit of skipping with the gold one. But that can easily be solved with just rewriting the word again, like I said before. But I'm impressed. They're really nice. I would say the tip may be a little bit too broad for my handwriting, because I write quite small. But that's just something that I have to keep in mind. And I think if I would use it for like decorating a spread, or maybe do some like bigger hand lettering, it will be perfect. So yeah, I'm really happy that I got these and I got to try them out finally. And then I was like, well, let's just try those markers on black, but obviously that doesn't really work. And then I was like, I'm just gonna try all of them. And of course they didn't work, because they're really not made for black paper, and they do kind of show up a little bit, but then when they're like fully dried, you really don't see them at all. So that's something that doesn't work, but also didn't expect it to work. So I guess that's fine. I don't actually know of any markers that would work on black paper. Usually it's either the gel pens or like the ones that are actual paint. But for these kind of markers, I've never seen them work on black, so that's okay. And same applies, of course, with the black pen, because it's black on black, so you won't see it. So that's a fail, a sad fail. And that's basically it. So I hope you enjoyed this. I'm really happy with my new pens. I think they're all great. And yeah, that's it. See you later. Bye bye.